inspired living. If you're new here, my name is Rina, and if you are a returning subscriber, welcome back and thank you so much for subscribing. Finally, in today's video, we are going to do the living room refresh, what I have been talking about for weeks. So fortunately, all the custom-made tables were finished in time for this video. So what we are going to do now is to do the living room, and later on in the video I'm going to show you a little bit of our Christmas decor downstairs, a Christmas home tour. This was how our living room looked like currently, before we remove the throw pillows and those elements on top of the coffee table. I'm sorry that I forgot to take a fresh video or picture before we remove them. This was from the last update, which I shared in a video entitled Decorating with Muted Colors. And this was how it looked more or less, except that the coffee table, the ones on top that I put, they change from time to time. So this is the living room when we have removed all the throw pillows. And this is the coffee table right now. That one there against the wall is the two-seater, and this one is the three-seater. I would have wanted to reorient them, the three-seater against this wall here, but it cannot fit there. I need two end tables plus the three-seater, and it will not fit. The whole set, the whole thing will not fit. So I really have to do with this setup right now. So now we are going to start the makeover. Neryo, our office caretaker, is here once again to help us with the carrying of heavy objects. For those of you who are new here and who have not watched my channel intro, I cannot carry heavy objects, even sometimes not too heavy ones, because of my illness. So I need assistance to do those things for me under my direction and supervision. So what I really want to do is to transfer this three-seater against that wall to make the space for the living room look wider. But as it is, it really can't fit with two end tables. So we are going to maintain it in this arrangement. Is the coffee table that our skilled worker Will has made. This is the one, and this is an Italian marble. It's pure marble. So he cut it and he polished it. This is a tubular steel that we used. And it's a good thing that Roel is also a skilled welder. And then we spray painted with metallic gold, two coatings, and then covered up for the third coating, another shade of gold, so that there are three layers. We also applied primer to the steel that we used to avoid corrosion. So this came from a very big slab of Italian marble, and it's called Blue Dunes marble. It's pure marble. It's like with a mirrored finish after polishing it. So I just love the design of this marble. That's why I chose it. It's quite expensive, yes, but it's a big slab of marble, and we were able to make two coffee tables and three side tables, and still there's a big slab remaining for future projects. This is a 40 by 40 square coffee table, that's in inches. And underneath here, underneath the frame that supports the heavy marble, there is a cross bar also made of tubular steel so that it can support the heavy marble securely. I didn't really plan to have the tables custom made like this, but I couldn't find something here locally in the Philippines that I really wanted. There are so many online. They are called luxury or the high-end ones, and the price, you have to break the bank to be able to buy them, and I just don't want to spend so much for, you know, something that we can also custom made with the help of our workers. So I designed this table and the side tables as well, which you will see later on. I designed them, we bought the steel and the marble, and then repainted the base. So that's what we did. And of course, we saved up a lot of money instead of buying them online from the high-end furniture store. And there are also the very affordable ones from Shopee and Lazada, but they are made of the fiber board. I think it's not real wood, so that won't last long. Maybe that's good for, you know, a student's apartment or if you are starting, but in our home interiors we need more sturdy furniture like this one. This one is quite an old reindeer. It used to be silver, and there were two, but we can't find the other one. But when we looked for them this time, it was so discolored. There were black spots that we can't remove by cleaning. This is what I did. This is the side that's been spray painted. The whole thing is spray painted, but this has not been painted on with gold yet. And it's just so boring, just silver like that. But here on the other side, which I'm working on, what I'm doing, I am lightly brushing with metallic gold and then wiping it off.
Painting the poet.
And then I am just going to wipe this off because I'm not really painting this gold, just putting in some patina. And this is the side table that was custom made by Ruel. And this is one of three, a pair for the living room. And there's also one piece for the library, which I will show you in a much later date. So this is the one. Look at that marble. So these are the pillows that I sewed a few weeks ago, which I also shared in a previous video. And here are they arranged like this. And I think that I made more than enough. And this is the lumbar pillow that I hand painted. I'm liking it. These two angels are made of brass and they are vintage, which I refinished again in metallic gold and pearly red paint for the wings, hair, and collar. Replaced the foyer console table and mirror with this one, which is antique nara. It's full of carvings with the twisted posts like that. Well, the carvings on the doors can't be seen right now because of this Christmas stockings that Timothy put there. I think that this one is better fitted in this area because the antique brass that was here before, it just looked so flimsy, like it didn't really belong, unlike this one. So I think that I really like this one better. I hand painted the names on these stockings. We've had this for a few years. I hand painted them in metallic gold paint. And this pair of vintage solid brass reindeer, I also refinished in metallic gold. They are vintage and really heavy. Another antique solid brass reindeer, which I refinished in metallic gold. It's also very heavy and larger than the two others that I have shown you. And this pair of mercury glass lampshades I got from an American expat who decluttered his condo unit. And I got this pair. The shade is made of very thick velour. It's like, yeah, it's velvet, but it's very thick. And you know what? I just love mercury glass. So I got from him 3 lampshades. Thank you so much for watching, and I do hope that you enjoyed today's video. For those of you who have not subscribed yet to my channel, please do so. It will greatly help my channel. And I hope to see you next time on next video. That will be, yes, I'm going to have a blue and white Christmas tea party in the garden. So see you. Thank you. God bless.